Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to this episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to show you how it's possible to move data in the cloud without having to download it first and then re-upload it. So, directly from the cloud to the cloud. Let's get started. There's multiple ways you could copy data in Azure, but today I want to focus on one. It's AzCopy. It's a tool, it's available, it can run on any platform. And if you go at aka.ms/azcopy, you will have more information. And the reason why I want to focus today on AzCopy is, in fact, you don't even need to download it and install it. It's already available to you through the Azure portal. So if we go in the Azure portal, so portal.azure.com, and we click here on this little icon, that's open the Cloud Shell. Perfect. And if we type azcopy --version, you will see that AzCopy is already installed. And what we want to do today is copy a zip file from a blob storage to another blob storage. And that's very easy to do with one command. Here, azcopy and then copy, because you could do many different actions, and have my URL for my source and another URL for my destination. I will do that, it will take a few seconds, and now I could see I have one file that was already transferred. Interested? Now let's see the details. So we'll go back here. That was the command I execute. So AzCopy, that's my name of my application. Copy, because today I want to focus on copy, but go at akms/AzCopy, you will have more detail about everything you could do with that tool. And then I have two URL. The first one is my source, and the last one is my destination. I could copy one file, multiple file following a certain pattern with wildcard if I want, or a full repository, a full folder. So here I'm using SAS token as a security. So the first part of the URL is my blob storage with my file. Here it's testzipper.zip. And then I have my SAS token. So how can we get those addresses and those SAS token? To do that, we need to go back in the Azure portal and we'll show you how to get those. And here we are back in the portal. Just I want to show you here, those two accounts are the file I'm using for this demo. So I'm taking a file, my zip file from this storage and copying in the other one. So we'll need to create a SAS token for each one of those. It doesn't matter if the storage are in the same account or a different account, it will work. You just need to go log in into that specific account and create a SAS token, just like I will show you right now. So let's say I'm clicking on this account. So here I'm in my storage, and what I want to do now is create that SAS token. So I could here search for SAS for Share Access Signature, or SAS token. That's an acronym, SAS, means Share Access Signature. So I'll click here, and now I have all the information, the form to give access. I strongly suggest you give the minimum permission you need. So if I know I will be only moving blob, I don't need to have all those three others. And now I want to do, let's say, container and object, and maybe I just need to read it or wire it. So give the permission you want. Also, pick the date you need. Just picking the date, let's say I'm having a 1 day window to run my process, and that's perfect. Once I have it, I could generate here by clicking that blue button at the bottom, and now I have it. So I could use my SAS token, or I could use directly the URL with everything included. I need to do that for both the source and the destination, and now I could have those URL inside my command, and that's how you run it. Once you have everything, you could open the Cloud Shell, or if you prefer, you could also run it locally. There is no problem with that. And then you will have it, and if we go inside my container in dev, we can see that my file is there. If you need more info, go at aka.ms/azcopy. You have all the information, the downloadable will also be there, all the information about all the commands and all the rules you could apply. I hope that helps. If you have questions, leave them in the comment sections. I'm always happy to help you. See you in the next one. Bye.